Hey there, this is René Molenaar, creator of networklessons.com, and in this video you will learn about Ether channels. So let me give you an example. Let's say we have two switches. And these two switches are connected to each other with a gigabit link. So let's say this is a gigabit link. Now, let's say that this gigabit link doesn't give us enough bandwidth anymore. Now, then we have a couple of options. The first option is you can replace the gigabit link with a 10 gigabit link, which is a expensive solution, but it will work. The other thing that you can do is you can add more gigabit links and bundle all of those links into an Ether channel, which is also known as link aggregation. So, for example, let's say we want a 4 gigabit link, then we can add additional links between the switches, and then we can configure those to be bundled, which means that we will get a single 4 gigabit link. Yeah? So those 4 physical gigabit links will be bundled into a single virtual 4 gigabit link. So that's a great solution. And if you're going to do this, then you have a couple of options. Yeah? You can do this manually, which means that you will bundle the links on this side and on the other side. And then you have configured your own Ether channel. Yeah? The other thing you can do is there are some auto-negotiation protocols. Yeah? So there are 2 protocols that we can use, and the switches will negotiate with each other to see if they can form a Ether channel. Yeah? Now, if you want to do this, then there are 2 protocols that we have. There's one called PAGP, and this is a Cisco protocol, so Cisco proprietary. You will only see this on Cisco switches. And there's a standard that was created by IEEE. And this is the 802.3AD standard. Yeah? So LACP is quite common because you can do this between switches like I do here. But you could also do this, for example, when you have a server. Let's say this is a server over here. And the single gigabit link is not enough. Then you can, for example, take 2 links, bundle the 2, make a 2 gigabit link out of it. And you can use LACP as the protocol for the negotiation to form the Ether channel. Yeah? So that's basically what Ether channel is about. There's one thing I should mention, which is a great feature of Ether channels. If you would have those 4 physical links, so without the Ether channel, since the switches are running spanning tree, the 3 of those links would normally be blocked, yeah? Because spanning tree would create a loop-free topology. But if you use an Ether channel and you make this virtual link, spanning tree sees this as just one link. Yeah? So normally spanning tree would block all of your interfaces if you have more than one link. But if you use the Ether channel, then spanning tree only sees one interface, one link. Yeah? So that's basically it. And in another video, I will show you how to configure Ether channels, doing it yourself, manual, but also with the automatic negotiation method using PAGP or LACP. But I'll do this in another video. For now, thanks for watching. I hope this has been useful, and till next time.